I'll just try to brief you what exactly riveted joints are. Here rivets is the topic that we were discussing. Now in this rivets we have seen two types of joints. One is lap joint, one is butt joint. Okay, lap joint nothing but placing the material one over the other, something of this kind. Okay, let us call this as material number one, this is material number two, or two sheets, two different sheets, place it one over the other to work like a single element. Okay, in a similar fashion a butt joint is arranged one side by the other. This is material one or sheet one, sheet number two. This is one type of arrangement. All depends on the requirement of the customer or the application point. Alright, now coming to the lap joint, we have seen a series of sketches like how exactly we need to present or represent front view and top view of a riveted component. Okay, this is what this we have discussed, and few things we need to remember that also we have seen. Like coming to the lap joint, I'll just try to give you some brief about lap joint, then I'll just move on to butt joint arrangement. Alright, more number of students are joining, let us allow some time. Meanwhile I'll try to focus on what we have discussed. Okay, so here we need to remember few of the specifications related. What are those? Diameter will be given to you. Diameter will be given in the question. Accordingly we need to calculate few dimensions related. For example, if it is snap head, which we have seen, okay, snap head will be of this kind. There will be a semicircular head followed by a shank portion, something of this kind. Shank, okay. This particular shank will have taper. These two lines are not parallel to each other. Again, I just try to redraw. There will be a snap head followed by a shank portion. Okay, now this shank is maintaining overall diameter as 1.60, this we have already seen, and a height of 0.70. these are the specifications that we need to remember. Now as we know D value from the given data, you can easily calculate the height and the diameter of the snap head. Similarly, the shank is maintaining a height of 2.25 D. this also we need to remember. Okay, so we have seen different types of riveted heads, out of which we are focusing on snap head. Okay, how to draw? If you are very much familiar with one simple head arrangement, then other things can be drawn so easily. Okay, these are the few specifications related to a rivet. This we call it as rivet with snap head. Okay, nobody will ask you in the examination about try to represent with the help of a snap head or some other type of head. Okay, they'll directly ask you to represent a riveted joints representation. Means you need to show the front and top view of a complete arrangement, not just the head arrangement. Okay, try to understand. All right other than that, we need to remember few more formulas related. What is pitch? P is nothing but the, I'll just try to, here P is called the pitch distance, represented with P, which is equal to 3D. What is this 3D? Now for example, we have seen the top view of this kind. There will be a top view of this kind. Just simply I'm just trying to draw so that you'll understand. There is an arrangement of this kind irrespective of the front view I'm trying to show you. Okay, here when you draw the top view, you will get, you need to draw the true shape of the snap head. Now coming to the true shape of the snap head, it is going to have, I'll just change the color so that you have a clear picture of it. You could see from the top a diameter of 1.6D. likewise, you need to show at least two, minimum of two or three rivets in a row. So the in-between distance here, the in-between distance, we call it as from here to center of one rivet to the center of the other, we call this as pitch distance P. That is equal to 3D. D value will be given to you accordingly. You need to calculate and show. Now this head is visible to us from the top, which is 1.6D. So it is visible. So that is the reason we have drawn a visible circle, dark circle, nothing but. Now the whole D is not visible from the top, so we need to represent something like this with a dashed line. We try to represent invisible things something like this. Alright, so this is called P, which is 3D. Okay, other than this, there is one more distance that we need to remember, which is 1.5D. 1.5D. Now this is the distance from extreme. I hope you people are listening. If you find any difficulty, let me know. Extreme end distance of both the sheets from the rivet center. Try to understand. Okay, extreme end distance of both sheets, wherever you both sheets in sense, wherever you are placing the rivet from that position till the end of first sheet and till the end of next sheet. Okay, not either sides. I'll show you now. I'll try to justify this 1.5D. I'll just try to justify that so that you'll understand. I'll erase this portion and show you. The idea is to you people need to know the terminology. That is very important, because unless you know the terminology, you don't understand. Okay, try to understand the terminology first. Later stage you can easily figure it out. Now again, what I try to do here is I'll try to draw a simple sketch of a rivet. This is sheet number one, this is sheet number two. I'm drilling. Now try to understand this concept. We have already discussed sheet number one, sheet number two. I want to rivet these two by drilling a hole from top to bottom and placing a rivet on the top, from the top or from the bottom, anything is fine, because ultimately you need to, with the help of pneumatic or hydraulic press, you need to press the complete arrangement, rivet, to get this shape. Okay, now what is this 1.5D means? This is the distance from center of the rivet, center of the rivet to the end of the sheet. Only one side, that is enough. 1.5D. Similarly, from the center to the second sheet, 1.5D. Try to understand. Okay, irrespective of these two ends, the other end of sheet number one and other end of sheet number two. Other end means this end. Other end of sheet number one, other end of sheet number two, could be any distance, any convenient distance. Okay, but we are not bothered about this distance from center to the other end. We are not at all bothered. Okay, this is not required. That can be taken conventionally. Okay, that you can consider conventionally according to the sheet space available. Okay, try to understand this one. So out of drawing the complete sketch, remembering these specifications of 1.6D, 0.7D, 2.25D, 3D pitch distance, 1.5D end distance dimensions need to be remembered. Other than this, you have one more specification, which is, I just try to mention here, theta, which is equal to 10 degrees. This angle need to be maintained. This angle will try to maintain at the extreme end point. Here we are considering extreme end as 1.5D distance. Here is the 1.5D distance. So what I try to do here is, here with respect to this vertical, with respect to this, I'll just try to enlarge so that you'll understand better. Now this, as this is the extreme end of sheet number one with respect to center of rivet, with respect to vertical, I'll try to draw an inclined line maintaining an angle with respect to vertical as 10 degrees. All right. Similarly, with respect to vertical, I'll try to draw a line making an inclination of 10 degrees. Okay. Where we'll try to avoid, try to understand this one, we'll try to ignore, or it will try to avoid the sharp corner of the sheet all the time. Not only sheet, any machine component sharp corner in case of mechanical field is going to be removed, because the idea is to avoid the losses, okay, or human hurts related. Here it is maintaining an angle of 10 degrees. This is also one more important specification or standard that you people need to understand and remember. Okay, these are the few important points which I would like to mention, as we have discussed already. All right, these are the few specifications that you need to remember. So if you could remember these, then again I'll just try to start the lecture. All right, let me clear the sheet and explain you again from the basic. Here rivets is the topic we are discussing, out of which I'm talking about a lap joint. Okay, coming to the lap joint, here how to develop a lap joint we'll see. Let us consider this as sheet number one, this as sheet number one. And here I'll just try to place one more sheet. I want to fix these two in such a way where these two work like a single element. Okay, this is sheet number one, this is sheet number two, having a thickness of T both. In our case, okay, if this is the case, if I place one over the other, we call it as a lap joint. If this is the position of the observer, then how the position is going to be, complete arrangement is going to be. I'll try to, initially what you people need to do, try to draw a vertical. I'm showing the construction part of a riveted joint. Okay, for that what I try to do, I'll try to place an axis line here, which will help me out. This axis line will help to place the distances properly. Okay, now from here I'll just make a mark of 1.5D. I'll drop a line, means sheet number one should end up here. Similarly to the other side also, I'll just make a mark of 1.5D. I'll drop a line. Now understand, try to understand, this line is important because where you need to end up your sheet number 2. This is important. And understand one more thing, whatever I'm trying to do, I'll try to figure out with the help of a construction line, which is 2H pencil. Okay, after placing these two conventionally at some distance, I'll just try to bring the sheet to the center. Okay, all right, now let me make the scale horizontal. I'll try to place it here to draw sheet number 1 first. From here you can take any distance, but it should end up at 1.5D. Similarly, maintaining a thickness of T, let me decrease the thickness. Yes, conventionally I'm not taking any distance. This is T. Similarly, sheet number 2 should start here. That can end up anywhere beyond the sheet number 1. Here, anywhere you can end up. So you can take the scale. Now this is how you need to draw. So I hope you understood now. This distance, this side of the sheet number 1 is, you can take it conventionally, and this side of sheet number 2 take it conventionally, but from the center, this distance 1.5D has to be maintained properly. Okay, so once you're done with that, try to draw with HB pencil required lines. All these are required lines. So I'm darkening it. This is the construction part. In the previous lecture, I have explained you the concept, in-depth concept, completely. Now this time I'm just trying to draw. Okay, this is how we need to draw. Till now it is fine. This is fine. Okay, there are two sheets. Now what I need to do, I'll try to take a drill bit, start drilling from now exactly at the center. I'm trying to drill a hole. I just tried drilling, just have a look. Okay, because I want to fix both of them, what I did with the help of a drill bit, I have drilled both the sheets from top to bottom. This is what happened. Okay, if this is the case, what I need to do now, I just need to get this snap headed shanked portion rivet. Okay, I need to take this or from the bottom or from the top, I need to place it. Okay, so I'll just change the color so that you'll understand better. Here I'm placing it from the top so that the head will get restricted here, and other side I'll try to place with pneumatic press, as I said. So you need to draw the same semicircle with 1.6D as diameter and 0.7D as the height. This is how you get. Okay, when the complete portion got inserted, this portion is completely invisible, so keep it with dashed lines, don't darken it. This is how the arrangement is going to be. And one more important point to be noted here is, this portion has to be removed just to plague the chamfer session. Okay, now what I need to do, with the help of a scale, maintain an angle of 10 degrees with respect to vertical. Let us imagine this as that 10 degree line. Similarly, this is the 10 degree line. Okay, this line is important because we are trying to avoid the sharp corner. Okay, this is having a thickness of T, both the sheets maintaining same thickness. Okay, this is how the arrangement is. All right, now coming to the next step. wait a minute. Yeah, I'm trying to middling things. Okay, fine. Now I'll try to take the projector lines from each and every vertices point, making the scale 90 degrees. So at this point, I'll try to take a projector line. Please try to concentrate because you have to finish off this sheet also. Now here, as I made a chamfer session, I could see two lines passing through parallel. This is one more, because now this arrangement, whatever I'm drawing now, is viewing from the top. Here is one more. If you find any difficulty, or if you don't understand or unable to understand, please you can ask me. When I view from the top, what I could see is, I could see this snap head, which is 1.5D of diameter, followed by I could see complete sheet number one. Complete sheet number one means I could see this overall length of sheet number one. This overall length of sheet number one. Similarly, but some portion of sheet number two is completely invisible below sheet number one, so that is not visible to me. So how to represent those things here? Okay, so try to concentrate now. Let me concentrate first on sheet number one, because that is visible to me from the top clearly. So it is starting this particular sheet number one. I'll take the continuous color now with the help of HB pencil. I'll start here. Now sheet number one is starting here. Let me take much space. Now this distance is conventional, you can take any distance from here, it is completely visible. Okay, and I'll just maintain a gap. That why I'm maintaining a gap, I'll tell you. And here again, up to here it is visible. All right, this is fine. And I'll try to end up sheet number one somewhere here conventionally. This is also my wish. I'll maintain a gap. I'll go with it. Okay. Now, why I'm maintaining a gap means I just want to place a zigzag line. To place a zigzag line, draw a simple vertical followed by 45 degrees line. Something like this. Similarly, here also. Wherever required, try to place it. Similarly, this you could see, this connectivity you could see, and these two lines are also vertical visible. That also I'll try to darken it. Now let me concentrate on sheet number two. Now when I view from the top, these two edges are not visible to me from the top, so this becomes what? Invisible edge dash line I need to represent with. Something like this. All right, now sheet number two may go beyond this, so I have to draw the extension. All right, and let me draw a straight line, zigzag straight. Similarly here I'll just try to match with this straight line, zigzag. You can place as many number of zigzags as you want, because that represents that there is some more sheet left over. But our idea is not to show the sheets, our idea is to show the representation of a rivet, position of a rivet properly. These two edges are visible, so we are not supposed to place a zigzag line over here. Okay, these two parallel lines, or else these two hidden parallel lines, there should not be any zigzag line, because this distance is already specified. 1.5D is a standard distance which is specified. So when you know exactly where exactly these parallel lines has to be placed, that distance never be called as a conventional distance. So those are specified distance, so you need to make it dark without any zigzag line, this kind of zigzag line. Okay, so here this distance is conventional, which is not clear, which is not there. This distance is also, the sheet length could be any distance, so here we are trying to place the zigzag lines. Try to understand. Now, again take the scale and try to rotate 90. From every extreme end point, extreme end point of 1.6D, I'm drawing two parallel lines, which will help me out to, and D also, which will help me out to draw the top view of the rivet. This line, I'm drawing D distance now, D diameter D. Done. All right, have a look. I got these many lines. I'll take the same color of a rivet, whatever I have used for the front view, so that you'll understand better here. Diameter is, we know that there is a diameter, but when I view from the top, this diameter is not visible because head is coming in between the observer and the D. So I'll try to make a invisible circle. Similarly, complete D is visible. This is the D. Similarly, at a distance of P, what we need to do? P is equal to 3D. At a distance of 3D, again there is one more hole and 1.6D. Okay, represent two rivets in a row, that is enough, because unless you represent two, there won't be any scope to show this particular 3D. That is the reason we are placing two and showing it the distance. Now after this, if you try to place 10 also, the distance in between going to be 3D only. So only 2 are enough. Okay, this is how you need to do the complete sketch. After drawing everything, you need to darken. Now whatever the visible portion, you just need to darken the visible portion with the help of HB pencil, something like this. This is visible. These two parallel lines are visible from the top. This line completely from the top, it is visible. I'm drawing the zigzag line or whatever the lines I'm drawing here, drawing it conventionally with the help of freehand, just to make you understand the concept behind. But you people need to draw with scale and pencil. This is how the arrangement is going to be. Okay, and try to darken the circles also. Visible. This is also visible. Now you need to draw with the help of compass, then easily you'll get it. Okay, now the same component I'll try. Now the time left is 6 minutes, ma. Please try to understand the concept of hatching. Now I'm going to explain you the concept of hatching. Now when we hatch the model, when we need to hatch the model, that is important. Now for example, there is a cutting plane here. This is the position or the movement of the cutting plane direction. Try to understand this as a hacksaw. Now this arrow represents that cutting direction. Arrows represent cutting direction. When I cut the model from top to bottom, this particular arrangement from top to bottom, what happens? For example, if I cut it from top to bottom, if the axis is placed exactly at the first rivet, at this particular first rivet, then what I need to do? I need to draw a cutting line here, something like this, from the center. Okay, this has to be represented on the top. Okay, followed by arrow has to be represented here. Means, with the help of a hacksaw, I'm trying to cut the model, complete sandwich. Sandwich nothing but one over the other, we have placed the two sheets, no? That is the reason I'm calling it as a sandwich. Then when I cut from top to bottom, this portion will be removed. This portion will be removed, only this portion will remain. And when I view from the front, this becomes a front view position. This becomes a front view position, as this is a top view position, okay? Now, this is not the cutting plane, try to understand. This is your cutting plane and this is the direction of the cutting plane. Then when I view from, this is a position. When I view from the front, what happens? Complete portion got removed. So the thicknesses are visible now clearly. To show those thicknesses, what we try to do? We'll try to hatch this portion. Saying that this got cutted. Only the sheet. As I said in the beginning lectures, that studs, rivets, screws, shafts, nuts, bolts, if they are cut the section also, they are not supposed to be hatched. This is how it is going to be. Then one more important point to be noted here is this edge becomes dark now, because that is visible to us clearly, and there won't be this edge. Alright, this is how the arrangement is going to be. So why we need to hatch the model, that we have learned from our conventional representation of material, which is our first topic in machine drawing. In a tabular column, we'll try to represent different materials and their patterns. So same logic will be applied here as this portion. I'll just try to this portion got removed completely. Okay, sliced and removed completely. And when I rotate this complete piece normal to the observer, what he could see is this is the sheet visible, this is also the sheet visible. As I have cut it from the center of the rivet, I could see a rivet of this kind. Okay, if the same cutting plane is passing through in between two rivets, then what happens? Sheets will get hatched and coming to this part, sheets will get hatched and coming to this edge will remain like hidden only, these two edges, and here you also find one edge, something like this. Okay, this is how you need to start and end up your riveteds. Now this is called single riveted chain lap joint arrangement. Single riveted, as I said in the previous session, again I'll try to explain when we go deep into the discussion. Single in sense, not a single rivet, nothing but single row. Chain means one falling behind the other or one falling in front of the other. It is not going in a deviation way, it is going in a straight line, so we call it as a chain lap joint. Lap means one over the other, we call it as a lap joints. All right, I hope you understood how to draw. Now you have a formula for this to calculate T or thickness or else the diameter, because in the equation they may give you T value or else they may give you D value. Accordingly you need to calculate. D is equal to 6 root T is the formula. If D value will given to you, T can be calculated. If T value given to you, then D will be calculated accordingly. All other specifications, all other nothing but 1.5D, 3D, okay, and 1.6D diameter, 0.7D height of the snap head, all these things can be discussed. All right, only 1 minute left, ma. If you have any queries, you can ask me straight away. Any queries you can ask me now. Do you have anything to ask about the discussion we have till now? Fine. So I take things like you understood all the points related. If you have anything to ask, you can drop your comment in the chat box. I'm going to end up the session now. Okay, no need to rejoin again. Please try to start drawing these sketches by taking D or T value. Better to take T is equal to 9 mm. T is equal to 9 mm, or 9 will be more, no, better to take T is equal to 4 mm. Take T value is equal to 4 mm, then D will become 12 diameter. Accordingly you can draw the sketches and go through your textbook, follow the instructions accordingly, do complete all the sheets. Okay, only 1 minute left. I'm going to end up the session. Within this 1 minute, if you have any queries, anything to ask, please go ahead. Send me your join us number so that I can keep it for future assistance. or further assistance. Okay, thank you for now.